Well, here's something cool I wanted to demo, and that is installing software to the PinePhone from the PinePhone. So this is an older Postmarket OS install, and I want to upgrade it. And I will do that using only the PinePhone, not using a third-party computer. So I'm connected to Wi-Fi here, and I'm going to download this image of Arch Linux ARM. Okay, so let's go to the assets here, and this should be the right image. So save file. And now it's going to take a while. So now I need to, while it's finishing, 20 seconds left, I'm going to grab an SD card. I was planning to get a new one, but I didn't want to go out too much because, you know, the pandemic situation. And so I'm just going to use an old one. And that's this one here. Now it's completed. So let's put in that SD card here quickly. This is my UBports 2GB PinePhone, by the way. And okay, so now the SD card is in there. Let's see if it's if it's going to be recognized. LSBLK. Yep, that's looking good. There's a 28.9 gigabyte large disk. We're going to do this all on the terminal. We're just going to type ls. Maybe we should go to the downloads folder, cd. And then extract that file. That's going to take a while. Oh yeah, now finally. So now let's go lsblk again. And now let's just dd this input file is, hope tab completion works. No, of course it doesn't. And this tiny keyboard of old Postmarket OS is really, it's so tough to use, but yeah. PinePhone. IMG of equals slash def slash MMC BLK 0. Block size is 4 megabytes, and let's try with the status equals progress is implemented here, so that there's something to show about this. Oh yeah, invalid argument. So none of that. And now we have to wait again. this is the SD card device /dev/mmcblk0, and mmcblk2 is the internal memory. It seems odd, but that's the way it is on the PinePhone. And that looks great. Looks like this actually went through here. So let's take this back in my hands and type sync. Okay. And now we should be able to reboot. And I will just hit reboot now. Okay, I can't because I'm not root. But let's see how that goes. Ask for my password. And now it's restarting. And if everything went well, it should now be starting Arch Linux ARM. And that red light there looks like that's working. It's vibrating. And here we go. That's Arch Linux ARM. Now, this here is the initialization process of F2FS, the flash-friendly file system, which was developed by Samsung and is in the mainline kernel now and is gaining more features all the time with almost every kernel release. Even encryption is coming. I don't know whether it's in there yet, and if it's in there, it doesn't always mean that you should be using it already. So this looks quite strange, but I think it has to do this to expand to the whole SD card. Oh, now something different is happening. Okay, so looks like it's done. And I think it's going to start or reboot now. Here we are. Current release of Arch Linux ARM on SD card. Boom. So that's how you can install on the PinePhone to the PinePhone part one. EMMC installing on the SD card. Next up, I'm going to continue doing the other way around, and I'm going to install something from this image to the EMMC, to the internal memory. Stay tuned for that. So I had PostMarketOS Stable installed on this, and I decided to do the self-sufficient PinePhone stuff. So I I'm going to go to mobianproject.org. I hope that's even the right domain. And I'm going to go to downloads. Let's zoom in here, PinePhone. And then I'm going to go with the installer because I've always wanted to try this too, so I'm going to tap this, and now it's asking me what it wants to do, cancel or save file, and of course I want to save the file, and it's downloading now, and now the installer is completely downloaded. That's great. So I'm let me try GNOME Disk again, because I tried that on the earlier part that I just recorded and didn't stream. So let's try to install it. It must be something like pacman-s. Well, let's do a full upgrade in the process. Why not? And then GNOME Disk Utility, I think. Great, so that apparently worked. If it's a xz or xz compressed file, it can extract that, but since Mobian is coming as a gzip, that's not going to work here, so I'm going to have to go to the folder here and then I think that should be the right command. That's it, tab. Okay, once would have been enough. And let's unzip that. That's going to take some time. So now it finally extracted. I'm going to say restore disk image, and here that's the right device. MMC is MMCBLK2, and the SD card is 0, which is maybe confusing, but well, that's how Pine64 decided it to be, so we're going to live with it. And now we can do open this image, and it's a lot smaller than the target device, but that doesn't matter. And we're going to hit start restoring. And now, well, all existing data will be lost. Well, that's not a problem, because I never really used that post-market OS stable image I put on there. By the way, that was during a live stream too. And now I'm authenticating, and it's restoring the disk image to the eMMC. So great, so Mobian should now be successfully flashed to this PinePhone. I hope you can read those labels here. So that's how it's partitioned right now. There's a boot partition, then there's free space, and then there's another partition that contains that installer, and I'm going to go through that installer right now. And therefore, I need to turn the power off and take out that SD card. Hope it's properly shut down. So this is that SD card I was using. That's rather slow. It's made by Kingston, and I paid €3 for it. Whatever. Perfectly fine for that money. Now. Let's start that Mobian installer. Oh yeah, that's basically, I think, the same installer that I really don't like this keyboard, because the preview is so similar in color that I always think, oh no, did I hit the wrong keys? And I'm just going to use that same pin I've been using on, that's the default on Arch. And now I will enable full disk encryption and use some stupid password. How about linmop11? And again. Okay, now it will begin. So I managed to install an operating system from the eMMC to the SD card, then rebooted, downloaded another OS to that SD card, and flashed it to the eMMC, all on the PinePhone without any other computer, just internet connection and a power supply. So in my view, that PinePhone can be, at least if it's one where the video out works, can be in theory your only computer. It's going to be slow, but if you choose the right apps that work on slow hardware, then it could be fine.